In the name of our Creator, Redeemer, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
We are coming to the table of plenty provided by Jesus through the resurrection. Let us take a moment to prepare ourselves so His abundance might be ours. God, you came to heal the contrite. God, have mercy.
God, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. The Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand. God, have mercy.
God, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
People of the world. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of the world.
Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit. So rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the captain and the court officers had brought the apostles in and made them stand before the Sanhedrin, the high priest questioned them, "We gave you strict orders, did we not, to stop teaching in that name? Yet you have filled Jerusalem with your teaching and want to bring this man's blood upon us." But Peter and the apostles said in reply, "We must obey God rather than human beings. The God of our ancestors raised Jesus, though you had him killed by hanging him on a tree. God exalted him at his right hand as leader and savior to grant Israel repentance and forgiveness of sins. We are witnesses of these things, as is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him." The Sanhedrin ordered the apostles to stop speaking in the name of Jesus and dismissed them. So they left the presence of the Sanhedrin, rejoicing that they had been found worthy to suffer dishonor for the sake of the name. This is the word of God.
Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out. Let's cry out in joy to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Hearken to me as I sing my love of the Lord, who answers the prayer of my heart. From death unto life. Oh, let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. To the
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, looked and heard the voices of many angels who surrounded the throne and the living creatures and the elders. They were countless in number, and they cried out in a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches, wisdom and strength, honor and glory and blessing." Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea, everything in the universe, cry out, "To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honor, glory and might forever and ever." The four living creatures answered, "Amen." And the elders fell down and worshiped. The word of our God.
Thanks be to God.
God be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, Jesus revealed himself again to the disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. He was revealed in this way. Together with Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, Zebedee's sons, and two others of his disciples, Simon Peter said to them, "I'm going fishing." They said to him, "We'll also come with you." So they went out, got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. When it was already dawn, Jesus was standing on the shore, but the disciples did not recognize that it was Jesus. He said to them, "Children, have you caught anything to eat?" They answered, "No." Jesus said to them, "Cast your net on the starboard side of the boat, and you'll find something." So they cast it and were not able to pull it in because of the number of fish. So the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It's the Lord." When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he tucked in his garment, for he was lightly clad, jumped into the sea. The other disciples came in the boat, for they were not far from shore, only about 100 yards, dragging the net with fish. When they climbed out on shore, they saw a charcoal fire with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you just caught." Simon went over, dragged the net ashore full of 153 large fish. Even though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come and have breakfast." None of the disciples dared to ask Jesus, "Who are you?" because they realized that it was the Lord. Jesus came over, took bread, and gave it to them. In a like manner, the fish. This was now the third time Jesus was revealed to the disciples after being raised from the dead. It's the good news of salvation.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We continue the joy of this Easter season as we come again to that table of plenty. And today we hear Jesus say, "Cast your nets on the starboard side." You got to get the right side. If you throw to the port, the left side, you're not going to catch the fish. And so we're talking about where to cast our nets and what brings us to cast the nets. A few examples, some of them kind of obscure. One of my favorite people, especially as I was going into cross-cultural ministry, was a Jesuit named Matteo Ricci. Matteo Ricci cast his net in China. And he cast his net on the starboard side. And that meant that he went there. He learned their difficult language. He absorbed their customs, wore their clothes, so that he might understand what brought them growth, what brought them hope, what brought them a life. And so he cast his net in that way. And he was very successful, but the Jesuits didn't think so. And he was pulled out, but he cast his net on the starboard side. A couple of my other favorites because of cross-cultural ministry was St. Cyril and St. Methodius. They're called the Apostles of the Slavs. And they too, when they went into the Slavic nations, St. Cyril created or put together their alphabet, the Cyrillic alphabet, and then translated the Mass into the Slavic language, Cyrillic, translated the Bible so that the people might have access to the Word. And so again, they cast their net on the starboard side. They didn't have to go to the Slavic nations. Matteo Ricci did not have to go to China, but they cast their net on the starboard side. When I went into mission, it was with the Order of the Missionaries of Africa, which was founded by Cardinal Lavigery. And Cardinal Lavigery was the Archbishop of Algiers. And all of a sudden he said, "This whole continent does not have Jesus." He cast his net. And people kept coming, men to be brothers or priests, to go to Africa. And again, he said, "You come because you love Christ and because you love Africa."
If not, cast your net someplace else. And they came. And like Matteo Ricci and like St. Cyril and St. Methodius, La Vigerie wanted them to make sure they learned the language, make sure they understand the people, and to wear the same garments as the people in North Africa. And ironically, the nickname for the missionaries of Africa is the White Fathers. And people think because there was white people. No, it's because of the white garment they were wearing. And when they went into sub-Saharan Africa, they kept wearing that garment. And that's not what the people in sub-Sahara wore. I guess the priest didn't want to wear bark cloth. And so that name White Fathers caught on because of the cassock that they wore. And one of the people that I tremendously admire in the Missionaries of Africa was an elderly priest, French priest Louis Auger. And Louis Auger really knew how to catch fish. He cast his net into the Bemba world in Zambia. And he not only learned their language, but he created their grammar, because it was an oral language. And we people, we don't pick up on oral languages. We need that grammar. And he created that grammar so that people might have a touch with the Bemba. And he was so respected because of his knowledge of the language, because of his desire to learn from the people, that he was invited to places that no other white person had ever been invited to sit in some of their meetings where they were deeply involved in their tribal lives. He cast his net on the starboard side. And for all of us, we got all kinds of voices telling us where to cast our nets. And Peter, in the first reading today, says, we must obey God and not human beings. We must obey God and not those voices. Voices that say, cast your net in marriage or family or career or certain social justice objectives. None of those are bad, but obey God. Cast your net on the starboard side. That's God's side. The port side is not God's side. So how do you tell? Like Matteo Ricci, St. Cyril, St. Methodius, Cardinal La Vigerie, what looks like a place of growth for yourself? What looks like a place where you could learn more about love, learn more about compassion and hope? That's where we should cast our nets. And Jesus, we listen to him, and there'll be a big catch. I want to talk to the children. Kids, I don't know if you ever go fishing. And if you do, if you ever clean the fish, I'm not big on that. But Jesus was fishing, and then after the apostles came in from the boat, he said, well, let's have some fish along with some bread. And sometimes we associate Jesus with the Greek word for fish because there's a fish that when you open it up, you see Jesus. May you see Jesus all over the place.
Prayer helps us to know where to cast our nets, so let us turn to God now with our prayers and our petitions.
Our responses, Risen Christ, hear our prayer.
Risen Christ, hear our prayer.
For the Church, that empowered by the Holy Spirit, we may give convincing witness to the freeing and healing power of the Risen Christ, let us pray.
Risen Christ, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, that God will strengthen and inspire him as he leads the Church in seeking the reign of God, deepening our loving service, and growing in unity as God's family, let us pray.
Risen Christ, hear our prayer.
For our families, that mealtimes spent together may be times of nourishment, healing, reconciliation, and encouragement of one another, let us pray.
Risen Christ, hear our prayer.
For the war-torn regions of the earth, for those in the military, and for those who promote peace through cooperation, collaboration, or negotiation, let us pray.
Risen Christ, hear our prayer.
For our children who are receiving First Reconciliation and First Communion, that they grow in their love of Jesus, let us pray.
Risen Christ, hear our prayer.
For what other intentions do we want to pray?
Oh God, may we be reminded that the tomb is empty because Jesus is present in our lives, especially through this Eucharist. May our participation in this Eucharist help us to recognize that Christ in others and in our world, through Christ our God.
Amen.
We now take a moment to remember during this Easter season our baptismal promises as we turn to our God, remembering the mission that we've been given. I invite you to respond, "We do," as a sign that we are committed as a community to renewing our promise to live our baptismal responsibilities and to support one another in the call of the Holy Spirit.
Do you recognize God, the Holy One, as author of the cosmos, who recreates us in the divine image and is sovereign over all of creation and all time?
We do.
Do you accept Jesus as the Word made flesh, who, one in being with the God of all, redeemed us from our bondage to sin and death, and is the model for how we can live our lives?
We do.
As a follower of Jesus, do you pledge to pray daily, to meditate on the Word of God, to build community, to live a life marked by hope, and to celebrate the sacraments with faith, especially the Eucharist?
We do.
Do you acknowledge your need for compassion and forgiveness, and your vocation to be compassionate and forgiving toward those who might offend you?
We do.
Do you commit yourself to the gospel spirit of poverty and detachment, to resist the spirit of consumerism and materialism, to live a life of generosity, and to exercise a preferential option for the poor?
We do.
Do you dedicate yourself to seek justice in your personal interaction with others and in the world at large, to help others in their needs and in their aspirations, to work to end oppression and to reject evil?
We do.
We do.
Do you believe the Holy Spirit is at work in our midst, that the Church is universal, your grace with the cloud of witnesses, love of God, that sin is forgiven, that God's love for all of creation is unending, and that life is everlasting?
We do.
We do.
This is our faith. This is a faith of the church. We're proud to profess it in Christ Jesus. And let the church say,
Amen.
That my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty One.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
Receive, O God, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our God.
Amen.
God be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. On this, the most sacred time of the year, our Easter season, when Christ, our Passover, was sacrificed. For he is the Lamb who takes away the sin of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death. By rising, he restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O God, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, we pray, as we bring these gifts before you, just like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Mitchell, our Bishop, and all the ministers. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Alleluia. Amen. 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 Alleluia.
We pray as Jesus taught us, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of our God be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Offer one another a sign of that peace.
Have mercy on us.
Behold, O Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O God. Grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our God.
We are having some children in our community receive their first communion this week, and a child receiving his first reconciliation. So please keep them in your prayers as they receive their sacraments, and for all children who are receiving sacraments this May. If you have a birthday in May, please rise. May God bless you with peace and happiness on this unique day that you celebrate. And may that divine peace and happiness follow you the rest of your life. Have a blessed and fun birthday. On this special day of yours, we pray that God gives you all the joy and happiness that your heart can contain.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. Any presents can come to the office. God be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's go in peace.
Thanks be to God.